Greetings, everyone. It's Jonathan, Senior Smoke from the Ring of Fire in Westchester County, New York. I bid you welcome. Going to talk about another outdoor kitchen analysis. This is one of the better ones, I think, and actually one of the first that we really provided a turnkey solution to, because on this particular project, we not only supplied the grill components, but we supplied the island. We also supplied the fire pit and the fire pit burner. So we really were neck deep, to say the least, and we obviously designed it as well and did the installation. So let's talk about this. This build is in Bronxville, New York, here in Westchester County. And when the homeowner first visited me, he said, "Listen, I have two things I want to tackle here. I want a basic outdoor kitchen, which is going to be really close to the house because that's where the utility lines are, and I want to start digging trenches and pulling things all over the property. So it's got to kind of be next to the house without being on top of it. Because of that reason, they're going to leverage the indoor kitchen. So they didn't need to put, a sink, didn't need an ice maker, didn't need an outdoor refrigerator. We're going to leverage the indoor kitchen for that. But he wanted it to be super awesome. He also wanted a fire pit. And he was going to spare no cost on the fire pit. That was an important thing to him. So let's tackle this two different angles. Let's talk about the outdoor kitchen first. So he did not want to go high end. Lanx, Heston, DCS, Alfresco, et cetera, they were out of the question. He wanted something functional, something attractive, and then something that if there was going to be an issue, it would there'd be good service to back it up. And for that, we go to Blaze. I mean, Blaze, we've been selling Blaze now for 5 years. It is one of the more popular brands that we sell here. Blaze has quickly become one of the biggest grill companies in the United States. They've done a great job. We use a lot of the Blaze, the undercounter components. We use them in, the highest of high-end kitchens. If people don't want to spend the money on the particular grill brands, trash straws and things of that nature, it's a way to save some money, but to still get stainless that's cut in the United States. It's made in California. The grill isn't, but the undercounter components are. And, he had an idea as to what he wanted in terms of the components. So let's move this from left to right. First, what you're going to see is the undercounter is the dual trash and recycle bin, okay, which is one of the more popular Blaze pieces that we sell. Then under the grill, we have the AD40, which is the access doors, 40 inches, marries perfectly with the grill that he got. And no refrigerator. But you will notice an electrical box in the front. I'll talk about that later. Up top, what he did was he did a side burner, double side burner. And then he did the Blaze 5 LTE grill, which is the 39, 40 inch grill. Again, symmetrical over those access doors. And the access doors, which don't have any storage, he has the gas line teed to feed the side burner and the grill. And then to the far right, again, didn't want to pull utilities out there, so we did the Blaze, it's the ice bin. And he could fill that up with ice, put his drinks, his libations in there. He's good to go. The island is 10 feet, and we did provide the Ring of Fire outdoor kitchen solution for this, so we designed it for him, rendered it up, delivered it, dry fit all the pieces into it. And what we did here is that he needed to be near the house because that's where all his utilities were, his electric, his gas, but we couldn't be on top of the house. So I want to say behind the island is about 5 or 6 feet, give or take. And I think the gas shut off, if I remember, is back there. What he wanted, this was a change that came as the process was rolling on. He decided to go with a backsplash. And it was not a functional backsplash. He was not going to have a bar behind it or anything to seat people at. He just wanted the look of a backsplash. So what they did is, if you could see on the pictures, the countertop waterfalls, okay? So it continues on the backsplash face and on the top of the ledge. He did, I believe, the stone veneer he used. I think he used El Dorado, which is a cultured stone. It's a concrete product. And I don't know what countertop he used. I was going to say it's Dectin, but it's pretty thick, unless he had it mitered. So I'm going to have to ask him and see what countertop he used. But the color, the juxtaposition between the colors works phenomenally well. On the island component, before we jump over to the fire pit, I would have done two things differently, okay? Number one, I would not have put the GFI, the outlet box, in the front of the island facing out like that. Since he was doing a backsplash, we typically put the outlets on the face of the rising backsplash. That way it's, you know, if you wanted to put a plug in a blender or something like that, you don't have wires all over the place. In this situation, if they want to plug something into that outlet, the wires are going to drape around, and it's just, I don't like the way that looks. I also just don't like the way it looked that the box looks on the front of the islands. I would have definitely done that differently. The other thing is that he doesn't have any storage in this setup. Now, he may just have the access doors opened up and put his cover and his tools in there, but remember, that's open down there. So it is, not, it is, you know, if there are critters, dirt, et cetera, they're getting in. So I would have definitely put, you know, some type of storage component, even if it was like a two-draw system, a three-draw system, or in hindsight, maybe used the Blaze door and three-draw combo, the BLZ DDC 39. I would have used that under the grill instead of the access doors, because then he would at least have one access door, and then you have three draws for storage. So I would have changed that one thing. Other than that, it's beautiful. Also, end capped on the right side, you will see the vent. Okay, we recommend using vents on all of your islands. I don't typically end cap them, but I think that it's a smart idea to put them in the back of the island, behind the side burner. If you have it, any type of gas related equipment, you should have a vent behind it. And I think on this island, I don't have a shot of the back, but you should have vents behind both the grill and the side burner. That's it for the island. Moving over to the fire pit. An amazing job at the fire pit. What he did with this, the coping is made of bluestone, and then you can see there's a wall that he had built, which is bluestone and some type of rock over there. So he just basically emulated that with the fire pit. Bluestone coping, or the rock stone exterior. And what we did with this is we supplied, in the same, built of the same material as the island, we supplied the fire pit, delivered it, and then his guy put the coping on it and the stone. And then what we also did is we used the Warming Trends Crossfire burner, gas burner, to power the fire pit. He did not want a wood-burning fire pit. He thought it was just going to be too, it's going to be too nasty with the smoke. He didn't want to deal with maintenance. That's fine. The Warming Trend gives a beautiful high flame. You can actually sit around it and get warm. Okay, unlike like the outdoor fireplaces, which are a little bit challenged in terms of sending out, you know, warmth and heat. But this fire pit, which I don't recall the size of it, it may be 44 inches in diameter. It may actually even be a little bit bigger. But it's a he wanted it large enough to fit his family. He's got his wife and his three kids. They're good to go. And the feedback I've received from him, as he's had it now for quite a while, is that it absolutely slays. So he is tickled pink about both the island and the fire pit. It just looks absolutely astounding. So this is an important setup for people out there to see in this gallery, because it shows the true turnkey nature that we can provide, whether it's on a comfort product like a fire pit, or it's the island itself, or if it's just the grill pieces. So what I try to say is we work hand in glove with whatever style you want to work in. If you want us just to provide the grill components, so be it. If you want us to build the islands, if you want us to get into comfort with heat, fire pits, the heating elements, I mean, you know, it's just we can do it all. So, and that's what differentiates us, quite honestly, from, you know, going to an appliance store to buy a grill. All right, it's a totally different ball game. This is all done before all this crazy stuff happened this year. So while the kids have been quarantined from home from college, They've been getting a hell of a lot of use out of it and still do. So we can help you folks. Comfort products, fire pits, fireplaces, outdoor kitchens, et cetera, et cetera. Come to the Ring of Fire. We aim to please. Thank you very much.